We've got a great group coming up, one of my favorites, the Civic Dance Center, the Civic Ballet Company, that have been around for a very, very long time, decades. They're going to tell us about the story of Pinocchio, which is one of the favorite Italian-American traditions. And it's a tradition in Italy that's been around for, well, centuries. So with that, put your hands together for the leader of the Civic Ballet Company, Miss Helen Gauss.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you for coming, and it's a beautiful night. Thank God the rain didn't come down. Right. I'm Helen Gauss, Artistic Director of the Civic Ballet Company, and Robert Zaloga, right here, is Assistant Director. And all of the dancers are students of the company and members, and I hope you enjoy the performance as much as we enjoy bringing it to you. Our moderator is Chrissy Cerruti. Thank you.
Our story begins in a little village in Italy where a woodmaker and toy maker named Geppetto has created a marionette whom he named Pinocchio. Geppetto wishes upon a star for Pinocchio to be a real boy. As he sleeps, the blue fairy enters and makes his dream come true, although Pinocchio remains a puppet.
Thank you.
himself brave, truthful, and unselfish, he will become a real boy. She appoints Jiminy Cricket to be Pinocchio's conscience. Pinocchio to join Stromboli's puppet show, even though Jiminy warns him of the consequences. What he has done, Pinocchio tries to run away, but is caught by Stromboli and put in a cage. Jiminy tries to free Pinocchio, but cannot. Just then, the blue fairy appears and asks Pinocchio why he didn't go to school. Pinocchio knew he was in trouble, so he lied to the blue fairy. Which caused his nose to grow. He then told the truth, and the blue fairy restored his nose and made it possible for Jiminy to open the cage. Geppetto is frantically looking for his beloved Pinocchio, only to find him in a cage. Stromboli comes back. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.